Now let's see this program. C program to calculate the student grade in the examination. Suppose if the average is greater than or equal to 90, then print the grade as A. If it is between 80 to 99, then print the grade as B. 70 to 79, C grade. 60 to 69, D grade. 40 to 59, E grade. Less than 40, F. F stands for fail. So in this example, the inputs are some 6 subjects. Next, we have to calculate the average. So average is nothing but the sum of the marks by the total number of subjects. Next, based upon the average, we have to print the grade. So let's start the program. Let us write the program with the help of LC Flatter. So here the first statement is hash include stdio.h. Why? Because we are using printf and scanf functions. Printf and scanf functions are available in stdio.h. Next, main function. We know that execution of a program starts from main function. So let we have 6 subject marks. Let us assume that the marks may be of type float. So let us declare here some float. So float. So we have 6 subject marks. Let the first subject marks are denoted by m1. Next m2, m3, m4, m5, m6. So 6 subject marks. Next we have to calculate the total and average. So comma total, comma average, ABC. Okay. So these are the variables. In this example, the input variables are nothing but the marks. So first you enter the marks. So printf, before reading the message, let us display that information. You enter. So how many subjects we are reading here? 6 subjects. So you enter 6 subject marks. Next to scanf. Here the marks are of type float. So for float, the format specifier is percentage f. So we have to use this percentage f. So scanf. So how many percentage f's we have to use? We have 6 subject marks. So we need to have 6 percentage f's. So scanf, percentage f, percentage f, percentage f, 3 percentage. Next to 4th percentage f, 5th percentage f, 6th percentage f, comma, comma. So what are the marks here? M1, ampersand M1, comma ampersand M2, comma ampersand M3, ampersand M4, ampersand M5 and ampersand M6. Okay. Let us write, let us calculate total and average. So total is equal to, so what is the formula for total? Total is nothing but the sum of all the subject marks. So M1 plus, M2 plus, M3 plus, M4 plus, M5 plus, M6. So calculation of total is over. Next we have to calculate the average. So for average, the formula is total by number of subjects. So here the number of subjects are nothing but 6. So the formula for average is, average is equal to total by 6. Average is equal to total by 6. Okay. So with this, reading is over as well as total calculation is over. Next, average calculation is over. Next, we have to write the program. We have to write the LC Flatter based on these constraints. So let us erase these statements. So for space constraints, I am erasing these statements. Now let us write LC Flatter. So what is the first condition here? If average is greater than or equal to 90, if it is greater than or equal to 90, then what is the grade? A grade. So print of A grade. A grade. Next, the second condition. Else if, here if and else if are different words. Else and if are two different words. So between else and if we have to use a space, okay, because these two are entirely different words. So else if, what is the second condition? Average is in between 80 to 89. If it is 90, then it is A grade only. If average is greater than or equal to 80, double end. Why? Because these two conditions must be true. Double end, average is less than or equal to 89. If these two conditions are true, then the grade is B grade. So print of B grade. Print of B grade. So next one, else if. So use a space between else and if. Else if, what is the next condition? In between 70 to 79. Suppose if it is 80 average, then it should be B grade. Okay. So else if average is greater than or equal to 70, double end, average is less than or equal to 79. So then what is the grade? Between 70 to 79, the grade is C grade. So print of C grade. So print of C grade. So next condition, between 60 to 69, it is D grade. So else if 60 to 69. So else if average is greater than or equal to 60, double end, average is less than or equal to 69, then the grade is D grade. So print of D grade. So next constraint, else if average is in between 40 to 59, average is greater than or equal to 40 and average is less than or equal to 59. So if it is between 40 to 59, then what is the grade? E grade. So print of what is the grade? E grade. Else, in else if ladder, for last else, there is no need to specify any condition. If you want, we can specify the condition. Yes, else if average is less than 40. So when this else block will be executed, if average is less than 40 only, so there is no need to write if condition here. Else is sufficient. Okay, else, print of what is the grade? F, where F stands for fail. So F grade. Then how many curly braces we have to close? So only one curly brace, that is nothing but for main function. Now let's see how this program will be executed. We know that the execution of a program starts from main function. So totally we have six input variables here. So that message will be printed on the monitor. Enter six object marks. So that we have to enter six numbers. So let us assume that we have entered three marks like this, 80, 80, 80, 90, 90, 90. So where M1 marks are nothing but 80, M2 marks 80, M3 80, M4 90, M5 90 and M6 90. Next total will be calculated. So what is total now? So 8 into 3, 24, 9 into 3, 27. So 24 plus 27 means 7 fours, that is nothing but 510. Next average will be calculated. So average is nothing but total by 6. So 510 by 6 means what? 6 8s are 48, 85%. Okay. So first condition will be evaluated. If average is greater than or equal to 90. But what is average? 85. 85 is greater than or equal to 90. Condition is false. So control will be transferred to the next condition. So next condition will be evaluated. What is average? 85. 85 is greater than 80. True. Next, 85 is less than 89. 85 greater than 80, true. 85 less than 89, true. So both the conditions are true. We are using logical end. If both are true, then the entire expression is true. So print of B grade message will be printed on the monitor. So in this way, we can calculate student grade with the help of else if ladder.